We aim at making clinical proteomics 100 times more robust and 10 times faster. However, to get a better understanding of the potentials and perspectives of clinical proteomics and how it will influence clinical diagnostics and personalized treatment in the future, we will ask pioneers who are dedicated to making a difference for their 2-minute personal view.
Hello, Nikolai from Evosep. Today I'm here at the Johns Hopkins University School of Medicine to talk to Professor Akhilesh Pandey about clinical proteomics. So, Akhilesh, what do you think about clinical proteomics and how do you see the implementation of clinical proteomics in real patient care?
So I think clinical proteomics is definitely looming large on the horizon, and we can say that in clinical medicine, as many of us already know, mass spectrometry is already being used for metabolite profiling for inherited genetic disorders. And what is also not so frequently appreciated is that there are many large centers or labs that are currently doing clinical proteomics for diagnostics, but they may not be in the form of FDA-approved tests, but they may be lab-developed tests. So proteomics is already there. What we need is for it to become more widespread, also more robust, and in widespread adoption, in the sense that it is more affordable to be measuring many analytes all at the same time.
Mm-hmm. So what about in a perspective of the next 5 to 10 years? How do you see the future of clinical proteomics? Is it going to be a major player in terms of personalized medicine and personalized treatment?
Yes, I think in the context of personalized medicine, as you say, I think there is a great potential. As you already know, there is a lot of genomic and transcriptomic and metabolite profiling that is being undertaken on very large scales, and data are now starting to come in where people have done limited scale proteomic profiling, and it's being understood that when you monitor certain proteins as analytes in individuals over a period of time, we have the promise of being able to diagnose diseases earlier. Mm-hmm. And I think if we can diagnose diseases earlier, in some cases before they reach a stage where treatment is less feasible, I think it will be a very good strategy for us all to be able to use the power of proteomics. Mm-hmm.
So basically being your own control in these longitudinal studies.
Yes, I think we need to collect a lot of data on what is normal. We have taken many decades to figure out what is normal for the analytes that are currently being tested. But proteomics has the option of giving us hundreds of more protein levels. Mm-hmm. And we need to establish what is normal for each one of them and then study them across a panel of diseases, a large swath of diseases, including cancer. Mm-hmm.
And essentially becoming a major resource in terms of treatment and early diagnosis in the future.
Yes, absolutely. I have no doubt that it's going to play an increasing role in diagnosis, just as ELISA and pathology-based diagnostics already are playing. Proteomics is looking at the same proteins, but in a different way.
Okay. Thank you very much, Akhilesh. Much appreciated. And thank you for watching, and see you next time.
Thank you.